أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
الحمد لله الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، خصوصا على افضلهم وخاتم النبيين محمد الامين وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين. اما بعد، فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى كما ورد في سورة الرعد، اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الف لام ميم را تلك آيات الكتاب والذي انزل اليك من ربك الحق ولكن اكثر الناس لا يؤمنون. الله الذي رفع السماوات بغير عمد ترونها ثم استوى على العرش وسخر الشمس والقمر كل يجري لاجل مسمى يدبر الامر يفصل الايات لعلكم بلقاء ربكم توقنون. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم ربنا الهمنا رشدنا واعذنا من شرور انفسنا. اللهم ارنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وارنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى، امين يا رب العالمين. Dear brothers and sisters and sons and daughters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. With the name of Allah and invoking His help, we are beginning our study of Surah Al-Ra'd. As I have been telling many a times, most of the surahs of the Quran are in pairs. But there are certain surahs which are unique, which are munfarid, and there is no other surah like those. For example, the very first surah of the Quran, Surah Al-Fatiha, is unique. It has no pair. But then Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Al-Imran, they were a pair. Surah Al-Nisa, Surah Al-Ma'idah, they were a pair. Surah Al-An'am, Surah Al-A'raf, they were a pair. Surah Al-Anfal, Surah Al-Tawbah were a pair. Surah Yunus, Surah Hud were a pair. And then last night we studied Surah Yusuf is unique. And I told you that among the 14 surahs of the third group, the group of Makki Madani surahs, the 14 surahs are Makki, starting from Yunus, ending in the 18th part with Surah Al-Mu'minun. These are 14 surahs. But the 12 of these surahs, they can be grouped into four subgroups of three surahs each. Now in each subgroup, there is one pair and one unique. One pair and one unique. So we had Surah Yunus and Surah Hud alayhi salatu wasalam, a pair. Surah Yusuf, unique. Now we have another, the second subsection of three surahs. Surah Ar-Ra'd and Surah Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, they are a very beautiful example of a pair. But then Surah Al-Hijr, that is a unique surah. It has a style of its own. And rather, if we can reach Surah Al-Hijr today, tonight, then I shall tell you that it has, you know, actually a very peculiar position in this Mus'haf. So now we start, you know. Now look to these two subgroups. The first subgroup was consisting of a little larger surahs. Surah Yunus, 11 sections. Surah Hud, 10 sections. Surah Yusuf, 12 sections. Now we shall have this smaller group. This groups Surah Ar-Ra'd, 6 sections. Surah Al-Ibrahim, 7 sections. Surah Al-Hijr, 6 sections. They are smaller. Then you know the third subsection will be again, subgroup will be Surah Al-Nahl, 16 sections. Then Surah Bani Israel, Surah Al-Kahf, each having 12 sections. So smaller and a greater. Now out of these, Surah Ar-Ra'd and Surah Ibrahim, as I have told you, they are a pair. And you will see, the 43 ayat of Surah Ar-Ra'd are divisible in 6 rukus, 6 sections. That is, the average is 7 ayat in one ruku. In the same case, 52 ayat of Surah Ibrahim, they are divisible into 7 sections. Again, 7.5, average is 7.5 ayat per section. But look to Hijr. It has 6 sections, but 99 ayat. A very different style, smaller ayat. Because I told you that the surahs which were revealed in the beginning, they were of a different style, smaller ayat. But you know, just like the rivulets in the mountainous area, in the mountainous regions, the rivers are not very wide, but they are very deep. And the flow of water is, you know, very strong currents going on. But when the same rivers come to the fields, to the plains, now they are broad, you know, but you know they are slow and constant. So that is actually the best simile of the surahs which were revealed earlier. Small ayat, but the flow and the rhythm is very fast. But when you go later period of surah, of the Makki, and then the Madani surah, then you will find, you know, the ayat are larger in size. The flow, the rhythm, there is a divine music, all right, but the flow is not so fast. So you will find in Surah Al-Hijr, you know, all the qualities of those surahs which were revealed very early, they are present in Surah Al-Hijr. And this surah actually belongs to the early Makkan period, but it has been included in this group. Although this group, two groups of these surahs, they have most of them, the surahs which were revealed in the last 4 years of the Makki period. But this one has been added here. Now, just like Surah Al-An'am and Surah Al-A'raf, I told you, in Makki surahs, you know, in one of the group, there will be tazkir be ala illah, Allah's creative activity, Allah's signs, Allah's attributes, how He has created, how is administering this universe, all these ala illah. But in the second member of that group, that pair, you will find at-tazkir bi ayyamillah, the history of messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what happened to big nations, to the people of Hud, to people of Saleh, the people of Nuh alayhim salatu wassalam. So this is tazkir bi ayyamillah, reminding people and admonishing them, referring to the history, referring to the events, great events of their past history, and admonishing people, referring to the, you know, creative activity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His signs, that is at-tazkir bi-ala illah. So you will find in Surah Ar-Ra'd at-tazkir bi-ala illah. No reference to messengers, no reference to prophets. It's all, you know, the person of Allah, His attributes, and, you know, His omnipotence, omniscience, all these things, you know, they are stressed in Surah Ar-Ra'd. But again, we shall find in Surah Ibrahim reference to the messengers. But you know, the difference would be, we have studied these news of the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-A'raf, then again in Surah Uhud. But here you will find them collectively. Only Hazrat Ibrahim is mentioned in a little bit detail and naming him. But all, you know, Hazrat Nuh, Hazrat Uhud, Hazrat Saleh, Hazrat Lut, Hazrat Shu'aib, they are not being named there. Only collectively they have been mentioned. So this much should suffice, you know, as an introduction. And now we begin our textual study. Alif Lam Mim Ra. There are two surahs in the Quran which begin with 4 letters. We read Suratul Araf. Alif Lam Mim Saad. All the other which have read up till now, Alif Lam Mim, 3 letters. Suratul Baqarah, Alif Lam Mim. Surah Ali Imran, Alif Lam Mim. Then again, Surah Yunus, Alif Lam Ra, 3 letters. Surah Hud, Alif Lam Ra, three letters. Surah Yusuf, Alif Lam Ra. This is the second surah which starts with four letters. Like Alif Lam Mim Sad, Suratul Araf, and Alif Lam Mim Ra, it is Suratul Ra'd. Tilka Ayatul Kitab. These are the signs, these are the ayat, these are the revelations of the book. وَالَّذِي أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ الْحَقِّ. And what has been revealed to you, what has been sent down to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from your Lord, is truth, the total truth. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْسَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. But most of the people, they don't believe in it. اللَّهُ الَّذِي رَفَعَ السَّمَاوَاتِ بِغَيْرِ عَمَدٍ تَرَوْنَهَا. Now just, this one ayah, how profound it is, giving us the creative activity and the control of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of all His creation. اللَّهُ الَّذِي رَفَعَ السَّمَاوَاتِ بِغَيْرِ عَمَدٍ تَرَوْنَهَا. Allah is He who has raised high the heavens without any pillars which you can see. No visible pillars. ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى عَلَى الْعَرْشِ. Then He mounted the throne. فَسَخَّرَ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرِ. And He subjected the sun and the moon. كُلٌّ يَجْرِي لِأَجَلِ الْمُسَمَّى. All are running their own courses till an appointed term, appointed time. They will not be going on forever. It is أَجَلُ الْمُسَمَّى. There is a time which is appointed already. يُدَبِّرُ الْأَمْرُ. He manages and ordains all the affairs. He is the creator as well as the controller. Not only a creator, he is the controller. He is the runner of this show. He is the manager of everything. He ordains it. يُفَصَّلُ الْآيَاتِ لَعَلَّكُمْ بِلِقَاءِ رَبِّكُمْ تُوْقِنُونَ. He is explaining to you these ayat. Maybe so that you may believe in meeting with your Lord. لَعَلَّكُمْ بِلِقَاءِ رَبِّكُمْ تُوْقِنُونَ. So that you have belief and faith that you will have to meet your Lord one day. Now what's the relationship? Because you know the doubt which came to the minds of the people about resurrection was, how can it happen? When we shall all decay, our bodies will decay, we'll become dust like dust, and we'll be mixed, you know, in the clay. How is it possible that we can be resurrected? We can be created again? Now Allah says, if you believe in that Allah, who created all the heavens and the earth, who is controlling all of the universe, who is controlling the sun and the moon and all the stars and everything, do you believe He cannot create you again? If He could create you for the first time, you know, doing some job for the first time is more difficult. To repeat it is easy. Now you think that it is difficult to repeat your creation. He can create. So all these qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will remove your doubts about resurrection. وَهُوَ الَّذِي مَدَّ الْأَرْضِ. And it is He who spread out the earth. وَجَعَلَ فِيهَا رَوَاسِيَا. And put in it the mountains. وَأَنْهَارَ. And the rivers. وَمِنْ كُلِّ ثَمَرَاتِ. And He has, you know, produced all the fruits. وَمِنْ كُلِّ ثَمَرَاتِ جَعَلَ فِيهَا زَوْجَيْنِ اثْنَيْنِ. And from all the vegetations He has made pairs. And today we know, you know, I think when the Quran was being revealed, it was not in the knowledge of humanity that among the plants also there are sexes. You have the male and the female in each flower, the male and the female. And in the date palm especially, they have separate, you know, flowers, the male flowers and the female flowers. But these things, you know, they have come to be known now universally. Everything, it has sexes, it has pairs. يُغْشِ اللَّيْلَ النَّهَارِ. He makes the night cover the day. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمِ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Definitely, in these things are signs for those who reflect, who think. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do all this, why can't He resurrect you? Why can't He give you another life? وَفِي الْأَرْضِ قِطَعٌ مُتَجَابِرَاتٌ. And you find in the land, in the earth, there are plots, adjoining tracts. قِطَعٌ مُتَجَابِرَاتٌ. Adjoining tracts. وَجَنَّاتٌ مِنْ عَنَابٍ. There are gardens of grapes. وَزَرْعٌ. And there are the corn fields, وَنَخِيلٌ, and there are the date palms, سِنْوَانٌ وَغَيْرُ سِنْوَانٍ, and these date palms you find clustered also and in single positions also. يُسْقَى بِمَاءٍ وَاحِدٍ, they are all irrigated with the same water. وَنُفَضِّلُ بَعْضَهَا عَلَى بَعْضٍ فِي الْأُكُلِ, and we make superior some of them over the others in the taste. The same tract of land, the same water, you know, it is irrigating them. But you know, the dates of this tree are a different taste. And the dates coming from this tree, they have a different taste. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَعْقِلُونَ, in this there are signs for those people who use their senses, use their intellect. Now this diversity, you know, diversity of his creation, this also is a very big sign of the creative power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not that he can create only one thing or two things or three things, you know. Diversity you find. There's no monotony in the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Diversity of every kind. Now this is the concluding ayah. وَإِن تَعْجَبْ فَعْجَبٌ قَوْلُهُمْ. Now if you have to wonder, then the wondrous thing is that they are saying, what they are saying, إِذَا كُنَّا تُرَابًا أَيْنَّا لَفِي خَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ, when we shall be reduced to dust, when, oh, then we will be resurrected and created anew. This is, you know, this saying of theirs is actually, if you want to wonder, this is wondrous. Because if you see the whole of the universe, one who believes that we will be resurrected, it's nothing. Because if Allah could create everything and He is controlling all the universe, He can create. But actually, if you have to doubt, then you doubt their saying. Their saying is illogical. Whatever they are saying, it's absolutely irrational. Not believing in resurrection, but rejecting the possibility of resurrection, that is illogical. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ, they are the people who have disbelieved their Lord. When they say there can be no resurrection, what does it mean? They don't believe in the omnipotence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't believe that Allah is ala kulli shay'in qadir. So actually they are not rejecting the idea of resurrection. They are rejecting the attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ وَأُولَٰئِكَ الْأَغْلَالُ فِي عَنَاقِهِمْ, and there are iron chains binding their hands to their necks. وَأُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ, and they are the people of the fire. هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ, and they will dwell in it forever. وَيَسْتَعْجِلُونَكَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ قَبْلَ الْحَسَنَةِ. Now as I have been reading, you know, many times, they used to say, okay, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, now bring that chastisement. We are fed up of hearing these threats from you. And these people are asking you, O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to hasten on the evil before the good, قَبْلَ الْحَسَنَةِ وَقَدْ خَلَقْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمُ الْمُسَلَاتِ. So many exemplary punishments came to the peoples living in this very peninsula. They know it. What happened to Aad and Samud? They were the people of the same land. بَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَذُو مَغْفِرَةٍ لِلنَّاسِ عَلَىٰ ذُلْمِهِمْ. But your Lord is forgiving for the people despite their sins and evil doings. If He is not sending the final judgment, if He is not sending the final chastisement, if He is not showing any physical sign and miracle, it is actually the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He wants to give them more respite. And they, you know, they people, they want that the azab should come and the punishment should come. وَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَشَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ, and verily your Lord, it's very severe in retribution and punishment. وَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَوْلَا أُنزِلَ عَلَيْهِ آيَةٌ, the same thing. And these people who disbelieve, they say, why has not been any sign, any visible miracle sent on him? مِنْ رَبِّهِ, from his Lord. إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُنْزِرٌ وَلِكُلِّ قَوْمٍ هَادٍ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are only a warner. And for every nation, we have been sending guides. This is very important that I told you. This ayah again must be remembered. To every nation, وَلَكُلِّ قَوْمٍ, which we have been sending people who guided people to the right way. But only the history of the Arabian Peninsula and, you know, the Middle East, that has been repeated in the Quran several times. Because this was known to those people who were the first addressees of the Quran. Otherwise they should have been taught geography and history And then you know the names of the other messengers of Allah and other prophets could be given there. Allahu ya'lamu ma tahmilu kullu unsa. Allah very well knows what every female is carrying in her womb. وَمَا تَغِيْضُ الْأَرْحَامُ وَمَا تَسْدَادُ. And with what their wombs contract and dilate. You know, these wombs of women, you know, they are contracting after they have given birth to the child. They become very small. But as, you know, this fetus is developing in it, they dilate, go on dilating, they're dilating. So Allah knows it. When the womb is contracting, when the womb is dilating. Allah ya'lamu ma tahmilu kullu unsa, wa ma taghidu al-arhamu ma tazdad, wa kullu shayin indahu bi miqdar. And everything is with him according to a measure. Everything is measured. It's nothing haphazard which is happening. Neither the contraction of the wombs, of the uterus, is haphazard, nor its dilatation is haphazard. It's all ordained. It's all physiology. The laws of physiology are governing them. عالم الغيب والشهادة. He is the knower of the seen as well as the unseen. الكبير المتعال. He is the exalted one. And he is the great, mutaal and exalted. You know this Kabir, and we have one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Mutakabbir. Al-Malik al-Quddus al-Salam al-Mu'min al-Muhaymin al-Aziz al-Jabbar al-Mutakabbir. He is Mutakabbir. Now this word Mutakabbir, it's not used in a good sense. For if you say that person is Mutakabbir, no, it's not in a good sense. But Allah, to him, it suits 100% applicable. Al-Mutakabbir. So he is Habir, he is Muta'al. Sawa'um minkum man asarra al-qawla wa min jahara bihi. It's absolutely equal whether someone of you conceals what he is saying, you know, in very low voice, or he declares it openly. Wa man huwa mustaqfim bil-layli wa saribum bin-nahar. And the one who is hiding during the night, and the one who goes freely by the day. But what does it mean? Everything is in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَهُ مُعَقِّبَاتٌ مِّن مَّنِ يَدَيْهِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has appointed in succession, in shifts, the attendants. بَنَ يَدَيْهِ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِ. Whosoever is going out, he has the guards before him also and behind him also. يَحْفُظُونَهُ مِّنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ. And they are guarding him from divine command, from the command of Allah. Well, the time of his death has not come as yet. You have to guard him. These bodyguards are with us. Actually, none of us needs any bodyguards. When that appointed time of death comes, no bodyguards can save you. And till that time, that appointed time has not come, you know, nobody can kill you. So it's absolutely useless to have bodyguards. And we read, you know, in Surah Al-An'am, ayah number 61, Yursilu alaykum hafaza. He sends on you the guards, you know, they guard you, they keep guarding you. They don't let you die before that appointed time comes. Inna Allah la yughayyiru ma biqawmin hatta yughayyiru ma bi anfusihim. Now this is a very big and very fundamental principle of sociology. Verily Allah doesn't change the conditions of a nation unless they change the conditions of their souls. If you are good from within, you will have good conditions. If you are yourself bad in intentions and in your souls, then something bad will come to you. If you want to change your conditions, because if you are downtrodden, it is because, you know, something was wrong in your souls. You know, these colonial powers couldn't, you know, rule us unless we were not weak from within. If we had iman in us, they couldn't capture us and conquer us. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran clearly, أَنْتُمُ الْعَلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. You will remain supreme and the highest only if you remain mu'min. But when our iman became weak, well, you know, just as we find, you know, when the resistance goes down, now all the bacteria can have any effect that can attack you. But because of the knowing, because your own resistance has gone down, has been lowered. So actually when iman goes off, then the nation, the community, that becomes downtrodden. So that is it. And now you want that the condition should change. But you are not thinking of changing you yourselves. Unless the condition within you, these change, the conditions you know you, which you are experiencing outside, they can never be changed. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. There is a very beautiful couplet in Urdu. خدا نے آج تک اس قوم کی حالت نہیں بدلی نہ ہو جس کو خیال آپ اپنی حالت کے بدلنے کا. You have to change yourself first. Then the conditions will be changed. وَإِذَا أَرَادَ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ سُوءًا لَا فَلَا بَرَدَّ لَهُ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He decides for some community, something bad, some punishment, now there is none who can turn it back. وَمَا لَهُم مِّن دُونِ اللَّهِ وَالٍ. And there is none except Allah who can protect them. هُوَ الَّذِي يُرِيكُمُ الْبَرْقَ خَوْفٌ وَطَمَعًا. It is He who shows you the lightning with fear as well as بَرْقَ خَوْفٌ وَطَمَعًا. And hope also. Maybe some rain is coming in our fields, you know, they are dry. So the harvest will be good. But maybe some storm is coming. Whenever there is this, you know, هُوَ الَّذِي يُرِيكُمُ الْبَرْقَ, where there is lightning and thunder, actually He shows you the lightning with fear as well as hope. وَيُنْشِئُ السَّحَابَ الثِّقَالَ. And it is He who brings up the heavy clouds. وَيُسَبِّحُ الرَّعْدُ بِحَمْدِهِ. And this thunderbolt, this actually glorifies Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His praise. وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ مِنْ خِيفَتِهِ. And all the angels also, out of awe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they also glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His praise. وَيُسْلُ السَّوَائِقَ. And He sends the thunderbolts. فَيُسِيبُ بِهَا مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيُجَادِلُونَ فِي اللَّهِ. And then He inflicts with that thunderbolt and lightning anyone whom He likes. وَهُمْ يُجَادِلُونَ فِي اللَّهِ. And they are disputing and arguing about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُوَ شَدِيدُ الْمِحَالِ. And He is severe in punishment. لَهُ دَعْوَةُ الْحَقُ. Now these words can be interpreted in two ways. لَهُ دَعْوَةُ الْحَقُ. For Him is the true prayer, the effective prayer. If you are praying Him, actually your prayers will be heard. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the power to grant them. But if you are praying to anybody else, all your prayers are going in vain. Nobody to answer. Nobody has the power to accept and deliver you from the difficulties in which you are praying Allah. And secondly, all that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling you for is the truth. Because we have read, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَاللَّهُ يَدْعُوا إِلَىٰ دَارِ السَّلَامِ. He also calls people. إِلَىٰ دَارِ السَّلَامِ, to the house, towards the house of peace. لَهُ دَعْوَةُ الْحَقِّ. وَالَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ لَا يَسْتَجِيبُونَ لَهُمْ بِشَيْءٍ. And as for those deities whom they are praying and calling, leaving Him aside, they are not actually, they cannot, you know, they cannot answer their calls, they cannot accept their prayers. إِلَّا كَبَاسِتٍ كَفَيْلِ الْمَارِ. And their similitude is to a person who stretches out his hands for water. Now just imagine if there is a deep well, there is water in it, and you know you want to stretch your hand to get the water, so that this water should reach his mouth. But actually the hand cannot reach that water, and that water cannot reach the mouth. وَمَا دُعَاءُ الْكَافِرِينَ إِلَّا فِي ضَلَالٍ. All the prayers of these unbelievers and disbelievers go in vain. They are just lost. Because nobody is there to accept these prayers and to answer these prayers. وَلِلَّهِ يَسْجُدُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ طَوْعًا وَكَرْهًا. And to Allah prostrates everything which is in the heaven and which is in the earth. Willingly or unwillingly. Not only all these things, even their shades and their shadows, they also, وَزِلَالُهُمْ بِالْغُدُوِّ وَالْآصَالِ, in the mornings and the evenings. So it's a very beautiful world picture. There is a tree standing. What happens when the sun rises on the east? You find that there is a shadow, very long shadow, lying down on the ground. Now as the sun is going up, this shadow is contracting towards that tree, as if it is coming up. And when it is noon, it is up, no shadow. Then now again, when the sun goes to the west, again a shadow. And it is becoming longer and longer and longer, as if now it is prostrating to the east. So actually the shadows are also making sajda to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the morning, they were making sajda towards the west. In the evenings, they are making sajda towards the east. Now this is ayat of sajda. We have also to prostrate. قُلْ مَنْ رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Ask them, who is the Lord of the heavens and the earth? قُلِ اللَّهِ. And you yourself tell them, Allah. قُلْ أَفَتَّخَذْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ. Now if he is the Lord of all the heavens and the earth, how does it come? How come you have taken besides him protectors? لَا يَمْلِكُونَ لِأَنفُسِهِمْ نَفْعًا وَلَا ضَرًّا. You have taken them as your protectors, although they don't have the power for even themselves for anything beneficial or for anything which is harmful. قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الْأَعْمَى وَالْبَصِيرُ. Ask them, can the blind and the seeing people be equal? أَمْ هَلْ تَسْتَوِي الظُّلُمَاتُ وَالنُّورُ. Or can the light and the darknesses be equal? أَمْ جَعَلُوا لِلَّهِ شُرَكَاءَ خَلَقُوا كَخَلْقِهِ فَتَشَابَهَ الْخَلْقُ عَلَيْهِمْ. Have they accepted with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala associates who have created something? And now, because they have also created something like the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, now they are confused regarding the creation, which is the creation of Allah and which is the creation of anybody else. But because I told you many a times, that you know these people, these kuffar and mushrikeen of Arabia, they believed that the creation all belongs to Allah. وَلَا إِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ. They will say, لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. If you ask them, who created all the heaven and the earth? They will certainly say, Allah. فَنَّا تُوفَكُونَ. So actually what they believed was that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the all-powerful Allah, he is one, he is alone, and he created all the universe. But there are smaller gods and goddesses. You know, they can be of help to us in the hereafter, on the day of judgment. They will intercede for us. And they can take us closer and closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they wanted to please them also, to offer them some sacrifices also. That was the shirk. Otherwise they didn't think that, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah has created half of the world and the rest of the half of this universe has been created by anybody else. No. وَلِلَّهُ خَالِقُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. Tell them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah is the creator of everything. وَهُوَ الْوَاحِدُ الْقَهَّارِ. And he is the one, the omnipotent, the irresistible. أَنْزَلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَا. Now you are seeing all these attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his creative activity, how he is running this universe, all these signs, you know, ala illah, they have been discussed here. أَنْزَلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَا فَسَالَتْ أَوْدِيَةٌ بِقَدَرِهَا. He sent down water from the heaven, and now the wadis flow, wadis and valleys, you know, in these mountainous regions. Because, you know, there's a mountain on this side, mountain on this side. Now there's going to be rain. Now all rain going to the down, to the valleys. Now these valleys become rivers. They are not rivers permanently. But when there is rain, all these wadis, all these valleys become rivers. فَسَالَتْ أَوْدِيَةٌ بِقَدْرِهَا. Every wadi, every valley has a catchment area. So the greater catchment area, the torrent is more strong, more deep. If the catchment area is small, بِقَدَرِهَا, every has its own, you know, size. فَاحْتَمَلَ السَّيْلُ زَبَدًا رَابِيًا. And the torrent carries over it a swelling scum. There is a scum, you know, over the water. وَمِمَّا يُوْقِدُونَ عَلَيْهِ فِي النَّارِ ابْتِغَاءَ حِلْيَةٍ أَوْ مَتَاعٍ زَبَدٌ مِثْلُهُ. And from that over which they kindle a fire seeking to make ornaments or wear rises scum. When, you know, the goldsmith, he is, you know, kindles fire over gold and to purify it, then you find, you know, that over that gold there is a scum also. But now what happens to this scum? كَذَلَكَ يَدْرِبُ اللَّهُ الْحَقَّ وَالْبَاطِلِ. This has been interpreted in two ways. In this way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strikes the similitude of the truth and the falsehood. The scum over the surface of the water is nothing. It's just visible, but it has no value. Really, water is underneath the scum. In the same way, the scum which has risen when you were cleaning the silver or the gold, it is nothing. Actually, the silver or the gold is lying below. This is the example. Although you know this batil, this falsehood appears, and it appears very awful. It has no reality. The reality is something which is hiding behind it or beneath it. But the other, you know, the interpretation is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He strikes this batil with haqq. And we have, you know, another example of this phenomenon in Surah Al-Anbiya, ayah number 18. بَلْ نَقْزِفُ بِالْحَقِّ عَلَى الْبَاطِلِ فَيَدْمَغُهُ فَإِذَا هُوَ ظَاهِقٌ. We strike the falsehood with reality. There is a striking. بَلْ نَقْزِفُ بِالْحَقِّ عَلَى الْبَاطِلِ فَيَدْمَغُهُ. And you know this haqq, the truth, it breaks the bones, of head bones, skull of batil. So this, there has been going on a struggle between haqq and batil. Many a times, you know, haqq came, jaal haqq, wazaq al batil. Muhammad came, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you know, this, the haqq, you know, it was struck against batil, and the batil, you know, it went off. بَلْ نَقْزِفُ بِالْحَقِّ عَلَى الْبَاطِلِ فَيَدْمَغُهُ فَإِذَا هُوَ ظَاهِقٌ. It goes. Again, batil appears, gathers his strength and comes. Then you know you need that people who uphold truth and reality, they should come up and they should strike again against this batil. So this goes on. And now let me tell you that this ayah, that there is come over the torrent, there is come over the, you know, ways of the goldsmith and so on, but this come goes. It dries away. It has nothing to do. فَأَمَّا الزَّبَدُ فَيَزْهَبُ جُفَانٌ. All this scum goes away. It doesn't exist. It dries up. وَأَمَّا مَا يَنْفَعُ النَّاسَ فَيَمْكُسُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. And as for that thing which is beneficial to the mankind, that remains in the earth. Water was beneficial. The scum was not beneficial. Scum goes off. Water was beneficial. It is absorbed in the land, and then it gives, you know, vegetation. كَذَلِكَ يَضْرِبُ اللَّهُ الْأَمْثَالِ. In this way, Allah strikes the similitudes. Now, in this ayah, we find, you know, a slight reflection of the dialectical process. Just as we have been finding, and this part of the dialectical materialism, the philosophy of Marx, is correct. These philosophies, you know, they are not totally false. There is element of truth in them. Now we see that there is some thesis. It creates an antithesis from its very womb and its bosom. Then there is a striking between the two. And then the result is a synthesis. So whatever is beneficial to humanity, it remains. Whatever is not beneficial, it goes off. But again, because it is actually the creation of human mind. It's not complete. There remains something, you know, some flaw remains over there. And this gives birth to another antithesis. Now that synthesis becomes thesis, and it gives birth to another antithesis. Then there is again a striking between the two, a collision between the two, and then again a synthesis comes up. So actually, the material world is definitely progressing in this fashion. So no doubt about it. We can see there was monarchy, kingship, aristocracy, feudalism. From its womb or from its bosom, democracy was born. Now there was a struggle between the two. And that was manifested by the French Revolution. But what happened? This democracy was also, it had flaws in it. Because it gave birth to capitalism. Now humanity was saved from the tyranny of the kings, emperors and feudals, but now the capitalists, you know, that became powerful, and the rest of the people, they were reduced to the position of laborers. Now this again is strife. Now it becomes a thesis, and then it gave birth to antithesis of communism. There was a struggle and strife between the two. And out of this strife came out socialism. And the socialism of Scandinavian type, you know, in which there is democracy also, and there is, you know, the rights of the laborers also secure. So this process is going on. And why it is going on? Because matter is incomplete. If you look to materialism only, if you take to materialism, this process will go on. It will not take you to perfection. It is only the divine light and the divine guidance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given through His revelations. That can give you a totally perfect system, balanced system, politically, economically, socially. It can be a just social order from every respect. Those who respond to their Lord, for them is the fairest reward, al-husna. وَالَّذِينَ لَمْ يَسْتَجِيبُوا لَهُ And those who don't respond to him, لَوَنَّ لَهُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا وَمِثْلَهُ مَعَهُ لَفْتَرَوْا بِهِ If they had possessed all the wealth of this world, and another, you know, two-fold of all the wealth of the world they had possessed, they would be ready to give it to ransom themselves. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ سُوءُ الْحِسَابِ For them there will be the evil reckoning. وَمَا بَاهُمْ جَهَنَّمَ وَبِئْسَ الْمِهَادِ And their abode is going to be the hell. And it is a very bad resting place. أَفَمَنْ يَعْلَمُ أَنَّمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ الْحَقِّ كَمَنْ هُوَ أَعْمَى Now just think. A person who believes and who knows that whatever has been sent down on you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from your Lord is the truth. For example, Abu Bakr. He knows that this is the truth. His own soul has testified to the truthfulness of this message which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down on you. Kaman hu a'ma? Can he be like the one who is blind, who cannot see? He cannot appreciate? Innama yatazakkaru ulul albab. Only those people who have understanding, they use their intellect, only they get reminded, only they can be admonished. الَّذِينَ يُوفُونَ بِعَهْدِ اللَّهِ Those who fulfill their covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَا يَنْقُذُونَ الْمِيثَاقِ And they don't break the covenant. Which was this covenant? Which we read in Surah Al-A'raf. أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ قَالُوا بَلَا Now those people who are true to this covenant, they accept Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as their Lord. They go on worshipping Him, obeying Him. وَالَّذِينَ يَسِلُونَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ And they join what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded to join. You know these relations of womb, silatul rahm, because you know people are joined together. The brothers and sisters are joined together at the womb of the mother. They have all come out of the womb of the mother. And then at the womb of the grandmother, the cousins, you know, they are joined. So these are the relationships between human beings. And these are, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants that you should have enough regard for these relations. But those who break them, they will be mentioned later. وَيَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُ وَيَخَافُونَ سُوَ الْحِسَابِ And they have fear of their Lord, and they always fear the evil reckoning of the Day of Judgment. وَالَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا ابْتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ رَبِّهِمْ And those who persevere in seeking the countenance of their Lord. Wajh, face, countenance. And what does it mean, the player? They seek the pleasure of their Lord, وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ And they establish the prayers. وَأَنْفَقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً And they spend for His pleasure from what we have provided them, secretly and openly. يَدْرَؤُونَ بِالْحَسَنَةِ السَّيِّئَةِ And they repel, وَيَدْرَؤُونَ بِالْحَسَنَةِ السَّيِّئَةِ They repel the evil with good. Now this is the picture that was at Makkah. People were calling names to Muslims and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh, you have gone crazy. Oh, this is that and that is this. But you know the Muslims had to be very patient. Not giving the reply in the same coin. No. يَدْرَوُونَ السَّيِّئَةَ بِالْحَسَنَةِ يَدْرَوُونَ بِالْحَسَنَةِ السَّيِّئَةِ They are, you know, defending against all these bad things with good behavior. Their response was good. They are calling names to you, and you pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Oh Allah, forgive them, because they don't know. Allahumma ahdi qawmi, innahum la ya'alamun. Oh Allah, guide them to the right path. Actually, what they are saying out of ignorance. They don't know it. They don't know what they are saying. They don't know what they are doing. So Allah, forgive them. يَدْرَوُونَ بِالْحَسَنَةِ السَّيِّئَةِ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عُقْبَ الدَّارِ These are the people for whom there will be the good abode of the hereafter. What is that about? Jannatu adn yadkhulunaha. There will be gardens and residential gardens, or the gardens which will have perpetual bliss. Yadkhulunaha, they will enter them. Waman salaha min abaihim wa azwajihim, and with them those of their fathers and their spouses, wa zurriyatihim and their progeny, wal malaikatu yadkhuluna alayhim min kulli bab. Those of fathers and spouses and progeny, man salaha, who have been reformed, who are on the right path. Maybe they are not of that level. For example, if there is a very, you know, highly spiritual person among the bondsmen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah is sending him to a higher level of Jannah. Now he sees his father, his mother, for example, his sons and daughters, his wife, for example, or the wife sees the husband. Although they are okay, they have also been admitted in Jannah, but not that level. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise the levels of these relatives of this person so that they should be with him. But the condition is man salaha min abaihim. They must themselves be, they must have you confirm the prerequisites and fulfill the prerequisites. But the level, you know, that can be increased so that this person, he is pleased to have his father with him, his brothers and his wife with him. وَمَنْ صَلَحَ مِنْ آبَائِهِمْ وَأَزْوَاجِهِمْ وَذُرِّيَّاتِهِمْ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ يَدْخُلُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ كُلِّ بَابٍ, and the angels will keep on coming to them from all the doors. And what for? سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ, saluting them, giving them salam. سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِمَا صَبَرْتُمْ, because of the patience and perseverance which you showed. Now in these two ayat you find the word sabr most importantly mentioned. وَالَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا ابْتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ رَبِّهِمْ, those who showed perseverance. This was ayah number 22. وَالَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا ابْتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ رَبِّهِمْ, and here in ayah number 24, سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِمَا صَبَرْتُمْ. Actually through the Makki period, the most important virtue was sabr. Because, as I have told you, it was the period of passive resistance. You have to convey your message. You have to spread this message of Islam, unity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the Muhammad is messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to go on spreading the message. And if people, you know, they are calling names to you, they are mocking at you, they are cutting jokes with you, or they are persecuting you, persecution, it can be verbal, it can be physical. You have to take everything with patience. No retaliation. This is sabr. This was the order of the day for 12 long years at Makkah. No Muslim was allowed to retaliate. Don't, you know, don't try to reply them in the same coin. No. The law is an-nafs bil-nafs, wal-ayn bil-ayn, wal-unuf bil-unuf. The law remains the same. The law is what in Torah, and the law is the same here in Quran also. But actually, this period of the struggle, this period of dawah, this is the stage of your movement. During this phase of your movement, you have to have sabr. No retaliation, no revenge. And that was actually the key to success, as I have explained in the lecture that I gave on last Sunday. This was the key to success. Because the general public, which we call the silent majority, they were seeing it, they were silent, they couldn't take the courage of standing, you know, and saying to Abu Jahl, you are wrong. They didn't have the courage to say this. But they were not blind, they were seeing what is happening to Muhammad. And who is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? What is happening to Abu Bakr, and who is Abu Bakr? What is happening to Bilal? Well, he did nothing wrong. He only says that there is no God except Allah, and Muhammad is his messenger. If he has committed a crime, this is the crime. Then he is being beaten like anything. He was seen being dragged, you know, with a rope in his neck, and he was being dragged like the dead body, like the corpse of an animal. Why? What for? Due to what? What crime of his? Not none. So actually, the sympathies of the general masses, of the people, of the silent majority, they were going in favor of these people who were calling them towards Allah, and that was the key to the success. So this sabr was most important during all this Makki period. That is why in the beginning you find even, you know, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in singular pronoun, فَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ وَهْجُرْهُمْ هَجْرًا جَمِيلًا وَلِرَبِّكَ فَاصْبِرْ. وَاصْبِرْ لِحُكْمِ رَبِّكَ وَلَا تَكُنْ كَصَاحِبِ الْحُوتِ وَاصْبِرْ وَمَا صَبْرُكَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. You know, find it in so many places. The advice to Muhammad coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Muhammad, take it patiently. Take it patiently. Bear it patiently. Show perseverance. وَاصْبِرْ وَمَا صَبْرُكَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ وَاصْبِرْ وَلَا تَكُنْ كَصَاحِبِ الْحُوتِ إِذْ نَادَى وَهُوَ مَكْظُومٌ. Don't become like that messenger of Allah who was swallowed by the fish. Hazrat Yunus alayhi salam. You have to wait for the express permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to leave Makkah. You can't leave Makkah without express permission. You have to be here and you have to take everything with forbearance. وَالَّذِينَ يَنْقُضُونَ عَهْدَ اللَّهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مِيثَاقِهِ. Now these words must be, you know, must remind you of the ayah of Surah Al-Baqarah. There we found, you know, وَمَا يُدِلُّ بِهِ إِلَّا الْفَاسِقِينَ. يُدِلُّ بِهِ كَثِيرًا يَهْدِي بِهِ كَثِيرًا. وَمَا يُدِلُّ بِهِ إِلَّا الْفَاسِقِينَ الَّذِينَ يَنْقُضُونَ عَهْدَ اللَّهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مِيثَاقِهِ وَيَقْطَعُونَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ أَنْ يُوصَلَ وَيُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ. This actually, the ayah 26 and 27 of Surah Al-Baqarah, these words are very much resembling. And this is a sign that the time of the revelation of these surahs, Surah Ibrahim and Surah Ra'd, was very close to the time of the revelation of Surah Al-Baqarah. Very near the event of Hijrah. Alladina yanquduna walladina, and as for those who break, yanquduna ahdallahi min ba'di misaqihi, the covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after having it confirmed, wa yaqta'una ma amara Allah bihi yusala, and they are breaking these relations which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had commanded that they should be joined, not broken. وَيُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ, and they are making mischief in the land. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ اللَّعْنَةُ وَلَهُمْ سُوءُ الدَّارِ. For them there is the lana, the curse, and for them will be the evil abode. اللَّهُ يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ. Allah is He who outspreads the provision for whomsoever He likes, gives Him more and more and more, plenty and plenty of it. وَيَقْدِرُ. And yaqdiru liman yasha, these are the words understood here. And for whomsoever He wants, He, you know, decreases it. He gives, He straightens it, narrows it. Wa farihu bil hayati dunya, and these people, you know, they are rejoicing, they are enjoying the life of this world. Wa mal hayatu dunya fil akhirati illa mata, while the life of this world compared with the hereafter is nothing but a passing enjoy or a little comfort. وَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَوْلَا أُنزِلَ عَلَيْهِ آيَةٌ مِّن رَبِّهِ. Again the same. And these people who have disbelieved, they say, why has not been sent any miracle, any clear visible sign on him from his Lord? قُلْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُضِلُّ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَهْدِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ يَتَوَلَّى. Tell them that actually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He leads whomsoever He likes astray. And He gives the guidance towards Him only to the person who turns to Him. Who intends to have the guidance, Allah will give the guidance. But who doesn't intend himself, well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to give him guidance. He's not going to show him those signs and miracles. They are gone. Gone are the days. That was the childhood of humanity. Now humanity has come of age. Now mature. Mentally mature. Now you have to think and understand for your own self. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Those who believe. And their hearts, they get satisfaction in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُ الْقُلُوبُ. Behold, these hearts, these souls can have satisfaction only in the zikr and in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You might have plenty of everything, all the, you know, luxuries, all the comforts, everything, but still, you know, you won't find that satisfaction of your heart. These hearts can only feel satisfaction if they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُ الْقُلُوبُ. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ تُوبَى لَهُمْ وَحُسْنُ مَآبٍ. Those who believe and do good deeds, for them there are blessedness and the very beautiful place of return, حُسْنُ مَآبٍ. كَذَلِكَ أَرْسَلْنَاكَ فِي أُمَّةٍ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهَا أُمَمٌ. In this way, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have sent you to a community before whom so many communities have passed. In this very Arabian Peninsula, the Aad and the Samud and so on, many communities and nations have lived. لِتَتْلُوَ عَلَيْهِمُ الَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ, so that you recite to them what we have sent down to you in revelations. وَهُمْ يَكْفُرُونَ بِالرَّحْمَانِ, and they are denying, rejecting Rahman. قُلْ هُوَ رَبِّي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ. Now this is another issue, because the name of the supreme deity with them was Allah. They objected, who is this Rahman? We know Allah, but who is this Rahman? You say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, we know Allah, who is Rahman? You'll find this discussed in detail in Surah Al-Furqan. And we are not going to accept Rahman, who is this Rahman? وَهُمْ يَكْفُرُونَ بِالرَّحْمَانِ قُلْ هُوَ رَبِّي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ, he is my Lord, and there is no God except him. عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ وَإِلَيْهِ مَتَابُ, and I have put all my faith in him, and towards him is my return. وَلَوْ أَنَّ قُرْآنًا سُيِّرَتْ بِهِ الْجِبَالُ أَوْ قُطِّعَتْ بِهِ الْأَرْضُ أَوْ كُلِّمَ بِهِ الْمَوْتَى, if there was, even there were a Quran by which the mountains could be moved, or whereby the earth were left asunder, and whereby the dead were spoken to, they would not have believed. Now this is actually addressed to the Muslims. As I told you when we were studying Suratul Anam, that maybe that some Muslims thought, that if they are shown the miracle, if they are demanding miracle, if their demand is exceeded, what's the harm? Maybe some of them really come to believe, maybe they are sincere in their demand. And even if they don't believe, at least they will have to shut up their mouths. They won't be able to say anything. Their argument will be finished. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have read all this, you know, in very great detail in Suratul Anam. Here the same subject. If we had sent down this Quran in a way that mountains were moved and the earth was cleft and broken and, you know, the dead were made to talk, even then they would not have accepted. They would never come to believe. بَلْ لِلَّهِ الْأَمْرُ جَمِيعًا, all authority belongs to Allah. أَفَلَمْ يَيَّسِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, are those who believe not convinced, and they are convinced that their concern has not been set at rest? أَفَلَمْ يَيَّسِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَلَّوْ يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ لَهَدَى النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا, if Allah had so desired, he could put all the humanity on the right path. Was it beyond his power? He could make all Abu Jahl and all Abu Lahab, could be made Abu Bakr Siddiq, could be made, you know, Umar Farooq. He could turn them into any direction if he had to use the force. No. Because he has created them for testing. خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا, and for testing, it is necessary to give them a choice, freedom of choice. And you know, they are exercising their choice, freedom of choice. Now you don't get perturbed over it. وَلَا يَرَالُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا تُصُوِبِهُمْ بِمَا صَنَعُوا قَارِعَةٌ أَوْ تَحُلُّ قَرِيبًا مِّنْ دَارِهِمْ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ وَعْدُ اللَّهِ, and there will the disaster cease to afflict them because of what they do, or it alights near their houses until Allah's promise comes to pass. This subject also we studied in Suratul Anam also, Ayat 42 to 45, Suratul Araf, Ayat 94 and 95. Whenever Allah sent messengers to any, His messengers to any community, He sent to that community small inflictions, so that if they can, you know, they can wake up, let them wake up. If they can repent, let them repent. If they are sleeping, maybe that they wake up from their slumber. But these things will come, continue coming before that hour when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's final judgment and final, you know, command comes. حَتَّى يَاتِيَ وَعَدُ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُخْلِفُ الْمِيعَادِ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't go back on His promise. وَلَقَدْ اِسْتُحْضِيَ بِرُسُلٍ مِّنْ قَبْلِكَ, and O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all the messengers before who came before you, they were also mocked upon. فَأَمْلَيْتُ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, and we gave them respite, those people who disbelieved, we gave them, you know, respite. ثُمَّ أَخَذْتُهُمْ, and then I seized them. فَكَيْفَ كَانَ عِقَابُ, and you can see how was the punishment which came to them, to people of Aad and people of Samud and so on. أَفَمَنْ هُوَ قَائِمٌ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ نَفْسٍ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ, now he who is standing watches over every soul for what he has earned, and he is Allah. أَفَمَنْ هُوَ قَائِمٌ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ نَفْسٍ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching and guarding every soul and whatever he has earned. وَجَعَلُوا لِلَّهِ شُرَكَاءَ, and they have made associates with that Allah. Nobody is like him. قُلْ سَمُّهُمْ أَمْ تُنَبِّئُونَهُ بِمَا لَا يَعْلَمُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Ask them, now you name them. Who are the associates? Who are the partners of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Or do you want to tell him what he doesn't know in the heaven and in the earth? أَمْ بِظَاهِرِ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ. Or you are uttering merely empty words. You are saying for the sake of argument. You don't believe in them. بَلْ زُيِّنَ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مَكْرَهُمْ. But you know, for these peoples who have come to disbelieve, their devices, their plannings, they have been made beautiful to them. فَصَدُّوا عَنِ السَّبِيلِ. And due to this, they have held back and they are stopping others from the right path. وَمَنْ يُضْلِلِ اللَّهُ فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ هَادٍ. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leads astray, now for him there cannot be any guide who can take them to the right path. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.